Good morning, children. In the previous video, we have learned pronoun and its type. Today, we will learn personal pronoun and relative pronoun in detail. Before going to personal pronoun, we will recall what is a pronoun. Okay, a pronoun is a word used in place of a noun. It's a substituting word, or a pronoun replaces a noun. We do not want to repeat the names again and again, so we replace a noun with a pronoun. Look at these sentences. Ria is my best friend. She is a great dancer. All admire her. Here, she and her are used in place of Ria. They are pronouns. Actually, they are personal pronouns. Okay, personal, yes, something related to persons. She and her are personal pronoun. Now let us see, Ria, instead of Ria, if we use Shekhar, then the pronouns will change. Shekhar is my best friend. Instead of she, he will come. He is a great dancer. All admire him. Got it? Now, Ria and Shekhar then. Yes, Ria and Shekhar are my best friends. They are great dancers. All admire them. If the gender and the number of subject changes, when they change, the pronoun also will change. There are three persons in personal pronoun. First person, second person and third person. First person is who is talking. The speaker is the first person. I'm talking. So, I is the first person. And second person, I'm talking to you. So, you is the first person here. And third person, I'm talking to you about him, about her. So, here, he, she, it are the third person. So, about her, him, all these are the forms of this. Let me give you an example. If I say, I need to talk to you, I'll write that sentence. I is the first person, talk to you. You is the second person, talk to you about her. So, here her is the third person. Various forms of personal pronouns are given in a chart and it will be easier for you to understand. Person. How many persons are there in personal pronoun? Three are there. First person, second person, third person. So, first person singular, I, used as object, me. Me will be the object of I. Possessive form, mine. Reflexive and emphasizing form, myself. And used both in masculine and feminine. The plural of I, we, used as an object, is object us. Possessive form, ours. Reflexive and emphasizing form, ourselves, used in both masculine and feminine gender. So, second form, it means second person. Second person singular you and plural also you. Used as object, both are you only. Possessive form, yours. In singular and plural, both yours. In reflexive and emphasizing pronoun, yourself, and in plural, yourselves. used for both masculine and feminine gender. Now the third person singular he, object him, possessive form his, emphasizing and reflexive form himself, and it is masculine gender. Now third person singular, if we use she, then her will be the object and hers will be the first possessive form. Herself is the reflexive and emphasizing form and it is feminine gender. Singular it, and in object also it only, there is no possessive form, and emphasizing and reflexive pronoun it will be itself and it is neuter. Plural it is they, object it is them, possessive form theirs, reflexive and emphasizing form is themselves. All genders these are using. In your textbook there is exercise number 2 is homework for you. Fill in the blanks with appropriate personal pronouns. This is homework for you. Now we will learn a relative pronoun. A pronoun that relate to a noun, to a group of words that follow, is known as relative pronoun. Who, whose, whom, which, that are the words most frequently used as relative pronoun. Sometimes as also used as relative pronoun. Here who, whose, whom are used for persons only. Persons. But sometimes who, whose is used with the non-living, for non-living thing also. Let us see example. The farmer who had no work immediately started plowing the field. Okay. The second sentence you see, the car whose headlights were on. The relative pronoun which is used for the things without life and for animals. Let us see some example. The house which had been lying vacant for a long time had been sold off. The house which had been, house is a non-living thing. Second example, the tiger which had turned a man-eater could not be located. The pronoun that is used for both persons and things. This is the man that I have been speaking of. Here that is the relative pronoun and noun it is the man. I have lost the watch that my father presented me on my last birthday. Here relative pronoun that, and this is used for things. We use that. Okay, we use that after adjectives in the superlative degree. For example, Kapil is the best fast bowler that we have produced. Is the best fast bowler. Superlative degree. So after that, relative pronoun that is used. We use that after all these words. All, some, any, none, nothing, only. Example, all that glitters is not gold. That is the relative pronoun all. The word all is there. Nothing that I did please my father. That is the relative pronoun. Look at this sentence. Both the car and its driver that now appeared looked shabby. The car is a thing and driver is a person. Suppose in a sentence, both we have two nouns, both a person or a thing. Then which relative pronoun shall we use? Yes, no, naturally we will use that. The relative pronoun what? Okay, what refers to things only and its antecedent is not expressed. we cannot see the antecedent here in the sentence. What is antecedent? Antecedent means the noun which a pronoun is used for. Okay, what cannot be cured must be endured. Here what means is that which. No, noun is seen here. So what is the relative pronoun? The word is also sometimes used as relative pronoun. Let us see some example. He is such a leader as the country needs today. Second, his problem is the same as yours. Is sometimes used, means it is used sometimes after the word such and say. In the first sentence, such is there. Here we use as, and here also same as. So it is used with the word, after the word such and say. I hope all of you have understood relative pronoun. Let us do exercise number 3 in your textbook. Exercise number 2, I have given you homework. I'll read the question. Pick out the relative pronoun, and their antecedent. Antecedents means nouns, the which noun the pronoun is used for. That is antecedent. First one, first sentence I'll read. The bees which were buzzing outside the window rushed in. The bees which, here which is the relative pronoun. The bees is the antecedent, the noun here. Second sentence, I could hardly believe what I saw. Here the relative pronoun is what, and we have learned that in relative pronoun, what refers to things only, its antecedent is not expressed. So here we cannot find any antecedent, no antecedent is there. And third sentence, she pointed out the way that led to the garden. That is the relative pronoun and the way is antecedent. Now fourth one, what followed next surprised us all. What is the relative pronoun and there is no antecedent. Fifth one, some friends whom I loved dearly have left the school. Whom is the relative pronoun and friends, some friends is antecedent. Now exercise number 4, fill in the blanks with relative pronoun. First one, God helps those dash themselves. The answer is who. Second one, this is all dash I need to prove my point. Second answer is that. This is all that I need to prove my point. Third one, listen to dash I say. What I say. The driver dash had a great presence of mind. Stop the vehicle in time. The driver who had a great presence of mind. Fifth one, you should make friends with such children dash are sincere. Here S R sincere, A S S. Why? You can see here such. When such and same are there we will use S. The sixth one, the sun whose rays give us heat and gives us Okay, whose rays give us heat and light is often worshipped as God. Here already written whose. There is nothing dash I would not do for you. There is nothing that I would not do for you. Now next, a young lady dash lived in our neighborhood came to our help. Who lived in our neighborhood? The ninth one, a young lady dash I knew came to our help. Here, a young lady whom I knew. Tenth one and the last one, these children are facing the same problems dash I have faced. Same is here. You will use as I have faced. Exercise number 5. Rewrite these sentences omitting the relative pronoun and putting the preposition in its proper place. There are total 8 questions are there. 3 we will do here and the rest are homework for you. First one, the lady to whom you were talking is the principal of this school. The lady to whom. Here whom is the relative pronoun. And it is written here, you have to omit the relative pronoun. You have to remove the relative pronoun. So we are removing the relative pronoun whom, and the preposition here used is to. So to, we, yes, turn to in its proper place, talking to. So the answer will be, the lady you were talking to is the principal of this school. Are these the paintings to which you were referring? So the relative pronoun here, it is which, and you have to omit this. And the preposition is. This is the preposition that we will shift after referring. Are these the paintings you were referring to? Now third one, is this the train by which you are leaving? Is this the train by which? Which is the relative pronoun that we are omitting, and by is the preposition here that we are moving here after leaving. In this, yes, is this the train you are leaving by? So the rest questions you have to do as homework. And in your textbook, 6th and 7th exercises are also there. That's homework for you. You do, and we will discuss the answers in Zoom classes. Till then, bye.